Britton here. I figured I'd finally show you what I've been talking about. So I have stuff off the bike right now. I've been taking pictures of the bike to get reference points. What you're looking at, back up here, is a last Vetter fairing, at least half of it. And you will notice, now granted it's not sitting where it should be, you will notice the placement here. It should be sitting further up and further back. This is the turret, and it sits, let me see if I can do this here, it sits up top, so that when you rotate the handlebars, this whole thing moves with it. And what I'm looking at right now, get an idea of what's there, what I'm looking at now is how I'm going to be mounting this, because traditionally, I say traditionally in that there's been one other person that has done this to their... Now, let me show you this. So this mates up with this perfectly. Okay? Give you an idea. And there's two of those. So traditionally, you mount it by putting a bracket here. You actually weld to the frame. But I have my VIN number here. At the bottom, I'm going to be making a bracket most likely that comes this way and then goes straight across as a bar, and it'll double as a footrest, and I might actually make forward controls for my right foot brake. Obviously there's no clutch on this bike, so I don't need to worry about that. So this is going to come out to that fairing, the bottom half, and it'll connect in, and then the top and the bottom, two of these pieces, will be I guess riveted at first, but eventually it'll just be fiberglass together, because this is fiberglass. And then that'll connect to the bottom piece, and then out of here, out of the top, there should be a connecting point. The problem I'm going to run into, not only is the VIN here, but there's really nothing else to connect to. I guess I could kind of connect to these if I make some special mounting that can connect to those. There's some screws down there I can feel. I think these holes up here, these two are for the pseudo tank, and then, or cubby hole, whatever you want to call it. And then these two, I think these belong to the ignition, but I'm not sure because I don't have any of the parts in yet to actually put the ignition on. And then traditionally, right up in here is where stuff is mounted for like the headlights, but I can't do that because when these turn, those mounting points will turn. So I need to make a mounting solution that'll stem out from here. It'll come out and come out to a headlight or multiple light fixture and provide support for this, because it's going to be right about here that there'll be a plate behind here, aluminum plate that'll have several holes drilled in it, and one of those bolts will be here. So at the end, you only have three bolts holding this whole thing on. It's not heavy. It's probably, let me think. There's 5 pounds over here. I don't think it's 5 pounds, though. No, it's not even 5 pounds. So one half of this, not even 5 pounds. So it's going to be pretty light. But when you add on the headlight and stuff, it's going to be a little heavier. Update from yesterday. I went through and removed all of this lovely vinyl, and the way I did that was with a razor blade and with some WD-40. And then when that didn't work, I brought out some carb cleaner and got most of it off. I left one sticker on, well, outside the DigiNow sticker, which I'm still waiting for my DigiNow, Brandon. I left on this one just because it looked cool. I think these are GoPro mounts, I don't know though. So I didn't take them off yet, because if they are, then I might leave them on, or I might adapt them, or take them off and save them. I haven't decided yet.